This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how to use the high-low method to estimate fixed and variable costs. There are some key points here that I want to make before we move on to the example that we'll be using. First of all, this is a quick and easy way to estimate costs, and it's typically used with another more accurate technique such as the account analysis approach or regression analysis approach, and both of those are described in separate videos. But this method, the high-low method, uses historical cost information from several different reporting periods. It could be monthly information for the last over the course of the last year. It could be last couple of years. Depends on the situation. But we're using historical cost information from several reporting periods to estimate costs. And using this approach, the high-low method, we pick out the highest and lowest activity levels, and we use that information to calculate an equation that will help us to determine our estimate of fixed and variable costs. This slide shows a summary of the four steps of the high-low method. We're going to go through each of these steps in detail with some data in the next few slides, but I wanted to give you a general idea of what these steps are before we do that. Step one is where we identify the high and low activity levels from the data set, the historical information that we will be using. Step two is then to take that information and calculate the variable cost per unit. Step three is to calculate the total fixed cost, and then we take that information in step four and plug it into this equation, y equals f plus vx. That is, we take our variable cost per unit that we figured out in step two and plug it in here, and we take the total fixed cost that we determine in step three and we plug it in here. Then we have everything we need to estimate y given a certain level of activity x. What we have here is the information we need to perform step one. That is, we're looking at, in this example, total production costs by month, and it looks like we have July through June, and the level of activity, that is, the number of units produced for each month. Remember, step one is to identify the high and the low level of activity, and you see that in red in this chart. January shows that we have a low of 2,900 units produced for the data set that we're looking at, and April shows that we have a high of 5,900 units produced. So those are the low and high levels of activity, and the corresponding dollar amounts are here as well for each of those levels of activity. So we're going to take that information, remember this information, into the next slide where we're going to perform step two and calculate the variable cost per unit. To calculate the variable cost per unit, we're going to take the cost at the highest level in the numerator minus the cost at the lowest level, and then we're going to take the highest activity level in the denominator and subtract the lowest activity level. And that gives us then what you see here, $380,000 minus $200,000 divided by 5,900 units minus 2,900 units. And again, that comes from the previous slide. That results in the cost per unit, V, of $60 per unit. And for those math aficionados out there, what we're calculating here essentially is the slope. We have two data points, and we are using those two data points to draw a straight line if we were looking at a graph, and from that, calculating the slope. In the old days, they used to call this the rise, which is the numerator, over the run, the denominator. So the slope, or the variable cost per unit in step two, is $60. Step three requires us to calculate the total fixed cost. And what we have now, what we know, is the variable cost per unit, this $60 right here. So we're going to plug that into the equation y equals f plus vx, 60 is the v part of this, and solve for total fixed cost. And really the only way to do that is to have a value for y and a value for x. And so what we're going to do is we are going to select either the high or the low activity level. Either one's fine, and that comes from two slides back. And plug it in, plug the information for that high or low activity level. I happen to use here the low activity level of $200,000 and 2,900 units. So we plug that in, Y and X, and solve for the total fixed cost. And what you see here is that the total fixed cost is $200,000 minus $174,000. That comes from up here, this $60 times 2,900 units. And we get the resulting total fixed cost of $26,000. So now we have what we need to formulate the equation, which I'll show you on the next slide. Step four, then, is to take the information that we have from the first three steps and plug it into our equation, y equals f plus vx. And again, some textbooks will use different terms here, but we're essentially doing the same thing across textbooks, and that is to state our estimate of mixed costs using this equation. So what do we know? We know that we have $26,000 in total fixed costs. That came from step three, and we have $60 per unit for our variable cost. We plug those numbers in here, and now we can solve for Y, plugging in a value for X. So as an example, we might expect in a future month to produce 4,000 units. If we want to estimate our total production cost, because that's what we're focusing on here, is monthly production costs, we would plug in 4,000 units for X and then solve for Y. How we would do that is to take then the $26,000 total fixed costs, and we would add to that our total variable costs, which we calculate by taking $60 per unit times 4,000 units. Our total variable costs then would be $240,000. That's this right here, $60 per unit times 4,000 units. And we would add to that the $26,000 in fixed costs. And the result would be, the estimate would be, $266,000. So to summarize, we took some historical information for our production facility, that is, we took monthly production costs, and we used that information to estimate our total monthly fixed costs related to production and our variable cost per unit related to production. With that information, we can plug in an expected future production level to estimate the production costs for that particular month. And we said, well, what if we produce 4,000 units? Let's plug that in and see what the result is. We did that. We took 4,000 units and multiplied it by $60 per unit, added our total fixed cost, and came up with an estimate in the future of $266,000 in production costs if we produce 4,000 units. There are some potential weaknesses in using the high-low method. This approach, first of all, only uses the highest and the lowest level of activity to establish an estimate of fixed and variable costs. So if we have 12 months worth of data, like we did in the example here, that we're using to estimate our total fixed and variable cost per unit, we're only using two data points, and they happen to be the most extreme data points, and we ignore the other 10 data points. So that is a weakness with the high-low method. If all the data points are fairly consistent, it's not a huge problem, but if we have some extremes, this could really be an issue because we may be using data points that do not represent the data set as a whole. Sometimes cost accountants will then throw out the highest and lowest points just to get rid of those extremes and then use the next highest and lowest points. Another way to confirm that our results are in the ballpark is to use this in conjunction with another method. So we might use a regression analysis or a count analysis or the scatter graph approach with this to confirm our results. And those approaches are discussed in separate videos.